Hi, Uncivilized Vitality, and this will be a review or a suggestion video of sorts. I'm not really sure, just a variety of things, for the tool family of fire and light. So this is one of the eight basic families of tools you should have with you in your all-day carry. I actually double up on this. I always have one of the small flashlights in my pocket and a small lighter. Right, and then I have a ferro rod so I can make fire. But fire and light is an important family of tools to have with you. You can start fire and you can even use this to light to see things. And usually we have this wrapped up in the like outdoor configuration with some candle wick and some duct tape and a little bungee cord. But that's upstairs in my bag and I just didn't want to go and get it. So I grabbed one of these out of the storeroom. So, and this is my little daily carry. So I'll just give you some options and some varieties of things you should have with you every day, from real simple to outdoorsy, and to maybe even some more more advanced flashlights, all right? Because there's just infinite variety of flashlights. So we'll go over these first. Like I said, usually I have a small lighter, ferro rod in my pocket and a flashlight. I carry a pistol most of the time. If you carry a pistol, you should carry three other things on your person with the pistol. Just consider them all part and parcel. You need, well, four other things. You need a holster, obviously, some way to protect that trigger from negligent discharge. You need an extra magazine. That's the biggest point of failure. You have to have a tourniquet, and you should have a light with you. So light, tourniquet, extra mag, holster, pistol. Those are the five things. So I've got these in my pocket. I can use this to start a fire and to see in a pinch. I have a small flashlight with me. This is a little Streamlight. I don't even know what it's called. Streamlight MicroStream. So this is a MicroStream. I like this because it's got a tail cap. It's pretty bright. In a minute, we'll turn the lights off at the end. And then in the dark, I'll shine the light on the UV sign and you can see how bright they are. I'll tell you what the flashlights are if I remember. And if you're a techie that loves all that sort of stuff, you can look up the lumens and the different things. I'm just going to talk about some of the functionality without getting into too much. I like this because it's cheap, cost me $20. It's one AAA battery, so it's easy to carry a spare battery. It doesn't take up a lot of room, and something I carry with me every day. The clip on this is pretty interesting because it's actually a two-way pocket clip. I don't know if we can see that or zoom in on that. Two-way pocket clip. I don't know if you can see it. All right, and then back up. So it goes down in a, for instance, a shirt pocket. It's a little clip like a pen, right? And then it's got a reversible clip so it can go on, say, the bill of a hat. Now this would work better on a stiff-billed hat like a ball cap, but you know, I could put it on there and use that as a headlamp or hands-free. I could tuck it into the band here, right? I like that because I keep it in my left-hand pocket or my off-hand pocket, and it's got, without showing you my ID, I just run that little clip down the front of the pocket on the outside of my wallet. So if I have my wallet, I have my flashlight there with it, right? So that's always in my pocket, that Streamlight. That's a great option because it's cheap. Mini mag lights are great. There's Surefire, Streamlight, Phoenix, Olight, and there's lovers and detractors of all those. I'm not going to get into that. Another simple thing you should have besides a personal flashlight on your person at all times and a way to start fire, small disposable lighter, that's great, is these chem lights, these glow sticks. They're super cheap. Grab these. I've got them in the Jeep. I keep them in my backpack. They're in the med kit. They're in my daily carry bag. It's just a great source of light. They're a little, obviously they're not reusable. They're, you know, not as ecologically friendly to have these, but in an emergency, it's good to have a few of these in your kit. So speaking of my Streamlight, there is a USB rechargeable MicroStream. So it's the same flashlight. It's a little bigger. But it just charges up for USB, and then it's got details like 250 lumens, holds a charge for, I don't know, a few hours, that sort of thing. This could be good, but I still prefer to have an extra AA battery if I don't have to charge my light with the power bank. Maybe that's something you're interested in because it doesn't use batteries. But so USB chargeable or just a AAA, this is a great light. I like it. It's just enough for what I need to get done throughout the day. I carry it with me all the time. I got this. This little one is from Olight. I forgot what this is called. This is the 3E EOS. So this is a little twist-on flashlight from Olight. And it looks like I let it run dead. But what are you gonna do? So this is just a tiny little light. This is nice, throw in your pocket. I don't have any pocket clip for it. It's got a little lanyard ring. So this would be neat if you're one of those types that's into a carabiner kit or a neck kit. Maybe you could put that in your lanyard. I don't like a lot of things hanging from my neck. Maybe my whistle and ferro rod necklace or a neck knife, but this is something you could band maybe to a small neck knife setup. So I carry my little minimalist on my belt, but maybe with a ranger band, I could kind of stick that on there. I don't know, just a little flashlight. That's a good one to have, little pocket flashlight. Right, so those are kind of all day carry ideas, and I'll go over those in a minute. But then when you go out camping, if you're going out family camping, a cool thing to have is a lantern for in your tent or under your tarp. Lanterns attract bugs, they're a little extra to carry. But if you're doing one of those luxury camps, like a level 3 or family camp, sometimes it's nice to have lanterns instead of reusing chem lights all the time. So these are a couple of options. These are old from Black Diamond. I don't even know if they make these anymore. But this is a little lantern. It's got a couple of these little hooks, so you can hook it on a guideline. I hang this in my hammock sometimes. Doesn't take up a lot of room, super light. It's got a high and low mode. I didn't bring any batteries, takes 3 AAAs. Doesn't take up much room. It's pretty neat. It's more of a diffuse lantern. It's hard to pinpoint, so it's not gonna replace your flashlight. But it's nice to have a lantern with you. This Black Diamond is also a lantern. Oh, I think I have batteries in this one. All right, we might get to demonstrate this one. So this one can hang. It's got a hook at the top. It can hang. I can pull it open and stand it, so it looks more like a traditional camping lantern. And it's just got that little switch. Yeah, it's got on and off. See if we long hold it. And then it dims down to almost nothing. So it's got one setting, and then you can long press to dim that down for reading. So this is a pretty good lantern. Believe it or not, this is actually too big and heavy for me to carry anymore. I only use that car camping. So lantern, that's good. Most of the time, most of us when we're outdoors are going to use some version of a headlamp. They have the benefit over a flashlight because without that clip, you end up sacrificing one hand while you're working or doing this and holding your flashlight while you're trying to work, which is kind of difficult in the winter or if you're trying to answer or communicate. So headlamps are better. I always have the ADC light with me, a small flashlight, because it's responsible to have that tool. And then when I go camping, I throw in a headlamp. So now I've got redundancies. I've got lighter, chem light, ADC flashlight, and then my main light source in the woods at camp is some form of a headlamp. Tons of headlamp videos out there. I got a couple examples here. I've got my Black Diamond. I don't remember. I think this is what model this is. I don't know if they have models on there. Nope. I don't know. Oh, the Cosmo. So this is a good light. It's got high, low, medium. I don't have any batteries in this. I was not prepared for this video. I don't have any batteries in this. It just takes the 2 AAAs. So I like that. Oh, looks like 3 AAAs. But it's shockproof, dropproof. I've got the Storm version of Black Diamond, which is a little bigger, and it's got a locking feature. This has got a high, low, medium, and a red strobe. And it's a great headlamp. You know, allows me to work hands-free at camp. I can angle it down so I'm not blinding people with my light, which is one of the biggest camp faux pas, is having your GD light pointing straight out into somebody's face. Sometimes you can't help it. We have a guy that comes with us all the time, earned his nickname a couple years ago, because he's well over 6 feet tall. We call him the Lighthouse now because he had this super powered battery pack headlamp, and when he would turn, he would blind all of us. So shout out to Hani, the Lighthouse. Headlamp. Here's another version of a headlamp. This one's less bright, less reliable, and it's this is that UST, one of those UST, I forget where you get these, like made in China. It's just got this little elastic bungee on there, but it's got a little plastic pull tab to protect the watch battery until you need it. So this is a great little headlamp just to wind up and throw in a bag until you need it, because then you can pull this little zip tie thing in the back here, put those little bungees up, boom, you got a little headlamp you can use to control where you're looking. It's orange, so you won't lose it. It's very small and compact, and it's got this unique kind of clip back here, so you can attach it to you can take it off these little orange bungees and attach it to like a pocket or something. Small, not something I'd rely on. The Black Diamond would probably be like my main type of headlamp, but it's just pretty neat, the UST, so it gave me a headlamp. Here's an old Princeton Tech that takes a couple of watch batteries. I forget the model. I've since lost the strap years ago, but it's got a couple of ways to mount this as well. You can put this on a headband. You can thread that through like any other headlamp, so that's nice, and wear it with a band. Or I just usually throw this one in my bag because I can use these different mounting options. I can tuck that on the bill of my hat. Let me see if I can tuck that down. Tuck that through there. For demonstration purposes, I can run that on the bill of my hat if I can thread that through. There we go. And then I've got this flashlight, again, mounted on the bill of my hat, and I can stick that forward. Right, and I slide that around. So that's right on the edge of my hat. Works better with a baseball cap, right? And then the light's up there. This one's kind of heavy and flops the brim. If you wear a boonie hat like I do and you've got these little foliage rings, I can thread the rings through the light, and I can mount that on the brim of my hat so it sits up there. Then I don't need the strap at all, and I can keep that in my pocket. Now I got my hat, so I can angle this down, I can see and use the headlamp. I like that because it saves space, and it's, you know, small and compact. So that's sometimes the headlamp I use. And this is one we've tried recently. This is a Claris HC3. They're pretty neat because it comes with the strap, but it also comes with that dual-mounted a different way to mount this thing. I'm going to take the strap off here. Kind of like the Princeton Tech before I lost this part. So this one is no batteries, no watch batteries, single use or triple A's. This one's a rechargeable. And it's got this little clip that goes on here, and it will slide on to the bill of a hat or a headband or a belt or paracord, but I can slide that up and sit that on the bill of my hat. I'm a big fan of these headlamps that attach to my hat, so I don't have to carry an extra cord or pocket cord. This doesn't work. Okay. I can also hook this one up, which I've done before, on my pocket, and then it angles forward off the pocket of my shirt, so it can hang like this and I can direct it. So sometimes that's handy. A couple neat things about this: it's got a high, medium, low. It's got a red light and then a red strobe. And I didn't charge it. I thought I had. It's got a motion detector, so you can turn that on, and then if you wave your hand in front of it 4 or 5 inches, it turns on or off. So this is good if you're hands-free, if you got your headlamp up here and you don't want to reach up and find that button, you can just set it to wave your hand to turn it on or off. If you wear that to bed or have it on your hat or maybe on your shirt at night and you turn over and you need your light, you can do that. Seemed cool at the time, but problem with this one is there's no lock. Same thing with the Princeton Tech, although when it's tipped back, it's got this little plastic part of the clip that protects the button from accidentally turning on in your bag. This one's kind of a single use UST, and I pull that out and use it. I don't actually use these, so I just, one of my emergency kits, I've never really used them. I don't know if it's going to turn on. The black diamond has got the ability to lock it so it doesn't come on or off. So that's pretty good. What I've taken to doing with this one when I use it, which I don't use anymore, which is probably why it's not charged, is I'll take a ponytail or a hair wringer or hair tie or whatever they're called now, and I'll just wrap that around there to make that little package to protect it from accidentally being turned on in my bag. So grab a headlamp or a secondary light, so kind of your main light source. And then if the batteries die or you can't find it or you lose it, you've always got your ADC light and or your lighter or your chem stick. So here's some different options. So here's some new options. I'm trying these out. I was pretty excited about this one, and I'll show you why. One is the Olight. Now I've carried this. This is the Baton 3, and I have the Peyrun or Perun, however it's pronounced, which is just the same light, but with a 90 degree angle head. This is rechargeable. The cool thing about this light, it's got a magnetic base. It's pretty small, it's pretty handy. It's got that same kind of double bi-directional clip. So for the bill of my hat, my pocket, or down in my pants, pants pocket, or wherever I want to clip that, so I have that light. It's got the little side button. I'll show you the different settings on this. And it comes with this case. You charge the case, and then you drop the flashlight in there, and you can get three full charges on your flashlight with this case. So I throw that in my backpack, I charge it up, and then I've got my ADC light, which I can hook to my hat. Again, it's kind of heavy, but I can hook that on the side of my hat and use it as a headlamp when I need that at night. Keep it clipped to me, and then I can just charge it up each day, and this will last a good long while at camp. So I got that Olight, and then I have the other one, which I could have brought down. Same light, but has an angle, so it's 90 degrees out, so it sits, and the light's on the top instead of on the side. So that's a pretty good light. I've had good luck with that one. And then I wanted to try a light where I could get the best of both, the straight angle or the head angled, so 90 degrees, I could switch them back and forth because there's a few out there. The first one I tried was this EDC flashlight from, I don't even remember. It's pure chinesium, as my son says, pure chinesium. But it's waterproof, drop proof, it's got a magnetic end, it's got the clip. And I thought, well, this would be cool. Oh, Beirut. Beirut. B-O-R-U-I-T. Beirut. It's pretty cool. Some downsides right away. It comes with the charging cord. It's got a neat bunch of features. High, medium, low. White strobe. It's got... let me see if I can turn this on. It's got an amber light. It's got a dual bright white light from the side. Another click. I got that red light. I turn on, I got a red strobe. Now I got alternating red and blue, which I guess is handy for when I impersonate the police. I don't know. I don't really do that. So it's got those features on it. And then it's got the white light side from the end. And it's got a bright, right? High, medium, low, and then a super powerful impulse of 1200 lumens. Long press to turn off. I won't go through all that. You can read the user manual when and if you get one. Here's the thing though. I got this. It's got that dual clip on the back. I figured I would just put that right on my shirt and it would serve the purpose of ADC flashlight and headlamp when I go camping because I could just angle it down, right? But no. Somewhere in their infinite wisdom of Chinese engineering, it only rotates down about 30 degrees. It rotates the other way about another 40 degrees. It doesn't go to the 90 degrees. I don't understand why they would have done that. And then it's got a magnetic base, but it's got the one magnetic pole offset, so when you hook it to something, it always swivels and doesn't really point where you want it to point. I like the variety of the lights on the side. I like that it's waterproof and has the lanyard stuff, but the magnet's stupid and the little angle thing is dumb. Hopefully the B-O-R-U-I-T company won't troll me on my blatant dislike of their product. I really wanted to like it. And for like 15 or 20 bucks, I was pretty excited. But what do you get? So after that, decided just to bite the bullet and look for the another one. This is a Woobin X3. And this one has all of those same features. Also made in China, but it's a higher quality. Maybe it's not pure Chinesium. Maybe it's a blend. But we open this up, pretty thick manual. And then this is the light. So this one, they did it a little better. It's got two magnets, so it sticks where you want it and stays in its position without swiveling. And the head rotates from 90 degrees. And it rotates in line, so you have a regular little flat EDC light. This one also has a little, let me see if I can turn it on. So I had to unlock it. The body glows blue. You can turn that off. I had to read through the directions to figure out how to turn that off. But the body's got this little blue glow, which the wife and I discovered on our hike at night that it's a little annoying because it's giving off too much light. But it's got this little display screen that tells you how much battery charge, what mode you're in, that kind of thing. It's got low, let's see if I can turn it on again, low, mid, high, higher, then the low again. And then it's got four modes, like low, medium, high, and then like a moon. And then if I go to this side, let's see if we can long press, turn that off. Go to this side, I can get the red, or I can get the red bright, the low and high on the red. And somewhere in here I can do a strobe with it. Let's see, 1, 2, 3. Oh, there I got a white strobe, 1, 2, 3 clicks. How do we stop that? Okay. And then 1, 2, 3, 4 clicks, locks it. Excuse me, trying not to sneeze. It's got this little lock on there, 1, 2, 3, 4 clicks to unlock it. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 clicks does something. Oh, turns off that blue, nice. And turns on the moon glow. So this is a pretty cool, it doesn't have the bi-directional clip. Obviously I can't get everything I want in one package, but it's got a pretty strong clip on there. I could probably slide that on the bill of a baseball cap, but not my boonie. It does have a couple other things that it came with. One was this, like the Olight, it's got a power bank, a built-in power bank. A recharging unit. It's kind of a built-in power bank. So it's got this, you charge this thing up and it'll recharge the flashlight a few times. And if I understand the instructions correctly, I can actually use this as a power bank and charge charge my phone or maybe my other headlamps. I can recharge that. And it's got, drop the phone, the light in it recharges. And so also, if I rotate this to the 90 degrees part, and then I've got a little angled light, maybe on the front pocket of my shirt, or just sitting up, or attached to something, doing some work. If I put that into the charger, turn it on, into the little block there, now I get the dual purpose of that lid is a, sort of a soft diffuser, which has served the same purpose as the lantern. So I get an angled light, a straight light, multiple modes with red and white, and I get a little diffuser function like a lantern. And then it's got this really cool lanyard, right, that clips on here. Right? And the lanyard, and here's another neat little innovation that was kind of neat. I can take this lanyard apart, and there's a Type-C to Type-C charging cable in there. So I can plug that in and find a power block or Type-C somewhere, and I can recharge that with the lanyard. So overall, I thought it was pretty neat and innovative. I think my only complaint about this one would be the clip. And I think I could probably, I'll look around for an aftermarket, maybe replace that. I like the flatness because it fits in my pocket. It'd make a good ADC light. And a like a main light at camp or a headlight. Oh, it also does wireless charging. You can charge this, share this from your smartphone. You can charge it and some other things. It's a Woobin X3. They got a whole series. Look up all the specs online. But I thought that one was pretty neat. I'm going to try it out this fall at a variety of camps as my ADC and main camp light. even though it's good to have some redundancies, it'd be nice to have this serve both purposes. I prefer for daily carry something simple like the Streamlight. It just, you just hit the cap, turn it on. I don't want something too complex, especially if I'm using this in conjunction with a pistol in a self-defense situation or something. I don't want to be fiddling through, how many clicks was that? 1, 2, 3, 4 clicks, you know, damn it, that locks it. You need something simple. But for all the other features it has, the rechargeable, the, shit, puberty, the rechargeable features, the diffuse lantern, the power bank, the angled head, the little readout telling me how much charge is left, it's pretty cool. I like it. So I'm going to use that this fall and try it out, but I won't be giving up my micro stream light for my ADC. And then, of course, you always have a lighter on you and a chem light tucked down in your bag. So fire and light, it's kind of four units deep there. I just thought that'd be a good video. If anybody has any interest in more details on those, shoot us a comment, leave a question below. What do you carry for your ADC light? What brands do you like and why? Where are some areas you've tried to cut corners? Like I said, I usually carry my ADC and lighter, and then I'll throw a headlamp in my camping gear. But I'm going to try out this single unit because I can eliminate power banks as well as some other things. A little too heavy for my boonie, which I certainly enjoy wearing. So leave comments, hit the like button, do all the smashing of the button. Rendell loves to hear that now. And like, share, subscribe. I think that's it.